蓝美洲的故事呢，你会发现这次同学取的剧本哦，都很喜欢取一些可爱的。那最后一组呢，就是俏皮组了。俏皮组呢，大家一般的印象，觉得哪种动物听起来很俏皮啊？买给小孩子的小时候的玩具，会觉得是俏皮动物的代表，会是买什么？可爱型的，一般可能会买到小猴子。那如果讲到比较狡诈的角色呢，大家就会挑到狐狸。所以呢，这一次下一组的故事啊，的确是跟狐狸跟猴子有关系的故事。所以呢，我们即将欢迎第六组的同学。那请大家稍等一下，因为我发现一支麦克风完全没电，因为今天的声量，大家他也很努力在吃大家的声音，请稍等哦。所以呢，我们先欢迎第六组的同学，他先为我们借一下前面的故事。那第六组同学呢，我先介绍一下，同学有王明柔、李浩宁、曹千源、黄子云、詹怡佩、赖怡婷、李云轩同学为我们带来的《猴子与狐狸》的恶作剧，掌声鼓励哦。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our performance. I'm Amber.
And I'm Vinci. Today, we are going to share a folktale that was shared from generation to generation in the area of what is now the country of Brazil in South America.
The original written version of this tale was first published in 1917 in Fairy Tales from Brazil by Elsie Spicer Ells.
In our adaptation,The naughty monkey and fox both like to tease other animals for their own enjoyment.
One day, as they are competing with each other for the best fruit, an old lady tries to teach them a lesson in humility and tells them about a special tree containing the most beautiful fruit ever. Well, later they listen, let's find out.
Please sit back and enjoy as we bring this tale, how the monkey and the fox became tricksters to life. I like those more. There are many animals in this forest that need it. Milo and Felix ran past the woman, both ignoring her words.
I'm the best. I'm going to win.
I refuse to lose to that stupid monkey.
What should I do? He thinks I have made a terrible mistake.
The old woman fell for a time until she came up what she thought was a great way of teaching Lotin those naughty animals a lesson.
You have both wasted so much fruit from so many trees, but neither of you has won. I'm going to add some rules to make the game more challenging.
That sounds great. What do you think, James?
I can do it better than you.
So it's decided. I challenge you both to see who can get the fruit, whose name is hardest to remember.
Hardest to remember? What is it?
Mr. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree, and stands on the far side of the forest.
The far side of the forest? That is too hard to remember.
How can we possibly remember that?
That's the challenge. Or are you not sly enough?
Of course I am.
Nothing is too hard for me.
Then I will help. I want one condition.
What?
You two have to work together. I will give you Milo the first half, and you Felix the second half. You will have to ask each other for each half, and then go together to get a food.
Fine. What are my words?
Oh, Mr. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree.
What are my words?
Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Please, 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 pretty please. Gimme my kakami.
Felix and Milo discuss how to get the fruits. My lyrics are, oh, Mr. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree.
Mine are Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Please, 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 pretty please. Gimme my kakami.
But we will forget the people in the tree. How can we remember all?
Let's make it into a song. Trying to remember is too lifeless, too difficult.
Okay, I have a guitar, I can play a melody.
Okay, let's practice.
Oh, Mr. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree.
Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Please, 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 pretty please. Gimme my kakami.
They sang the song and walked along until they reached the corner of the garden where the wonderful fruit tree grew.
Wow! It looks so beautiful. It must be delicious.
I can't wait to try some.
Then let's start singing.
Oh, Mr. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Pegasinha Minga Fongo Tree. Please, 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 pretty please. Gimme my kakami. What a beautiful color and what a delicious odor it has.
I have never in all my life been so near to anything which smells so good.
Milo and Felix had never seen such beautiful fruit before, and so they took a big bite of it. But oh, what face they made!
What is this?
This fruit has beautiful color and smells so good, but the taste is bitter and sour. It has such a nasty, nasty taste.
They threw the fruit as far as they could. That was terrible. We were both dizzy by its appearance.
I will never forget the tree's name now.
I'll never forget its taste. I won't take a bite of it ever again. However, at that moment, both of them began to smile.
As the same horrible idea came to them both.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Let's trick the other animals into coming to steal its beautiful food. We will want to eat it too.
Oh, what face they will make. It will be great. But then no animal will want to be friends with us.
Let's just say neither of us have tasted it. We can say we have driven the name of a big fruit.
Sly, my friend, this is going to be fun.
Both the fox and monkey began calling upon the other animals, telling them the amazing fruit tree they had just learned of. Hey, guys, have you heard of this amazing fruit we found on the far side of the forest?
It's the best fruit you will ever taste. You have to try it.
Well, if you say so, let's go check it out.
Is that true? for most of the animals had been tricked or heard of the horrible trick they played.